Hi Church, welcome to this morning's devotion, and I want to read some verses to you today from the book of Luke chapter 5 verses 1 to 7 from the Message translation. It says this: once when Jesus was standing on the shore of Lake Gennesaret, the crowd was pushing in on him to better hear the word of God. He noticed two boats tied up. The fishermen had just left them and were out scrubbing their nets. He climbed into the boat that was Simon's and asked him to put out a little from the shore. Sitting there, using the boat for a pulpit, he taught the crowd. When he finished teaching, he said to Simon, "Push out into the deep water and let your nets out for a catch." Simon said, "Master, we've been fishing hard all night and haven't caught even a minnow. But if you say so, I'll let out the nets." It was no sooner said than done. A huge haul of fish, straining the nets past capacity. They waved to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. They filled both boats, nearly swamping them with the catch. I want us to think for a moment about comfort zones. We all have our comfort zones. I was talking to a friend of mine recently who was actually saying that he was enjoying the lockdown because he was in a safe place. He was in his comfort zone. He was working from home. He was, as he put it, he was living the life of a hermit. I heard a well-known quote recently that says, "Life begins at the end of your comfort zone." And that is so true. You see, we live largely by habits. We do the things the same way because it's comfortable. Someone said the only people who like change are babies with dirty nappies. Maybe changing a baby's nappy would take you out of your comfort zone today. Many of us get scared when we even think about moving outside of our comfort zone. We cling to the known and choose familiarity over risks. So each of us are surrounded by these zones, but they can be barriers that make us feel cozy and secure. We like to be comfortable, but is that always the best for us? Change is good for us, especially if God says we need to change or we can change. It could even be that it's God's will that we do change our attitude or our lifestyle. There are times when we're not meant to stay where we are and take the easiest option. You know, there are situations in the Bible that move people out of their comfort zone. And on this occasion in Luke 5, Jesus taught Simon to step out of that zone. He asked Simon to pull out into the deep water away from the shore, begin to fish. And Simon begins to make the excuses that we worked hard and caught nothing. But he gives in. He surrenders by saying, "If you say so." When he pulled out to the deep and cast his net over the boat again, they brought in this huge haul of fish. The blessings began to come. The blessings were so abundant that help was needed. Simon was a fisherman, so we have to assume that he knew what he was doing. Many times, like Simon, we think we know what's best for us. And we build the knowledge up by setting patterns that keep us comfortable. We build comfort in all kinds of things, such as money, food, clothing, education, even family and friends. These things give us that sense of safety. There's nothing wrong with those things, but there's more in life for us to experience. And I think we are poorer if we never stop and ask God to show us if there is more for us to experience. When Jesus called the first disciples, he was asking them to leave everything behind, everything that had made them who they were up to that moment. Do you ever wonder if they stopped and pondered first whether or not to take that leap to leaving everything behind to follow Jesus, that leap away from their comfort zone? I'm not saying that being in a comfort zone is a negative thing in life, and I'm not saying that we should take risks just to leave that comfort. But I think it's a good thing to ask God to show us more, to give us those opportunities in life to grow us and to bless others, to have the heart and the attitude to declare, "Jesus, if you say so." And here's a final thought. Stepping outside of our comfort zone doesn't mean taking on something huge like climbing a mountain. What we are realizing in these extraordinary days is that stepping out and doing the small things make a huge difference. We're talking to our neighbours more, helping people in need, making that phone call, sending that message of encouragement. My prayer is that we will never be the same again. that we've stepped out of those places of comfort and broken new ground. And people are going to be better because of it. And so are you. Let me pray. Father, I thank you for your word today. I thank you, God, that we are in places of comfort, Lord, that we have the things that you have blessed us with. But Lord, my prayer is today, Lord, is that we will experience more that you have for us, Lord, that we can make a huge difference in people's life today as we step out of our comfort zones, Lord. Give us those opportunities to encourage others, to speak into other people's lives, to bless others, and to be generous with our lives. Lord, I pray that we will make a difference. In Jesus' name I ask it. Amen. God bless you all, and we'll see you very soon. Thank you.